So yeah, Black Judging Together versus 400 and Zenfer. And we are indeed on Fairyland, so that is the next match, and that is the last match, that is the finals. I am excited.
I'll be AFK for a minute.
Okay. I am excited, and Parzival is elsewhere. Presumably, also getting excited. So we just need everyone to get in, and everyone's in, and then the game can begin. Or we wait for Parzival. Not sure what's going to happen with that. Parzival might have asked to wait. Did Parzival say wait? Well, anyway. So, at this point, we wait. Aye. So, I mean, clearly 400 and Zenfer, they are the favorites to win this. I mean, 400 did a pretty decent job with a relatively random teammate during the Swiss part, and now it's just... Yeah, this is... Well, actually, no, never mind. 400 and Zenfer got third in the Swiss part. Black Duchy and Seguero got second. And at this point, Black Duchy and Seguero beat Google Frog and Orphelius, who got third. So I'm not really sure who I'd call favorite. Okay, we are going to be starting very shortly. Anarchid...
And I'm back.
Good timing. Absolutely perfect timing there, Parzival. So we are just starting the finals. Or potentially.
Alright, what map are we on?
We are on Fairyland.
Okay.
Yep. Oh, whoops. I need to set this as the finals. There we go, finals. So yeah, we're on Fairyland. This is going to be... I don't know if they actually took just your suggestion about time limits, but yeah, I'd say 400 and Zenfer is the favorites. But honestly, yeah, 400 and Zenfer, man, that was... We saw their match. They had a commanding lead over Anakin and Hokomoko. Like, the GBC team just couldn't do anything. Didn't see... I mean, saw a bit of Black Duchy and Seguero versus Google Frog and Orphelius. Oh, wait, no, other way around. We saw all of Black Duchy and Seguero versus Google Frog and Orphelius. We didn't see a lot of Anakin and Hokomoko, 400 and Zenfer. The Red Comet match, 400 and Zenfer had complete domination over it, so I wouldn't be surprised if that just continued. However, we will see what happens. We may see what happens. Oh, wait. Oh, shoot, the game started without me. What the heck? What? Ah. Okay, the game apparently started without me, and now everything's gone to hell. I can't...
Will not let you join?
Spring crashes every single time I quit. And the problem is that sometimes when it crashes, the game thinks I'm already in. And if it thinks I'm already in, it won't let me join.
Okay.
So that's been the problem. Ever since like 103 something, it crashes every single time it exits. I don't know why. But it crashes, and then there's a whole thing about safe mode, which hopefully was not engaged. Because I don't want it to be engaged, but I accidentally hit enter, so it might have been. Which means all my settings are screwed up, which means I have to do a bunch of other crap, and... Ah, shit, it was engaged. At least I think it was. Very hard to tell. Okay, well, I'm just gonna assume that everything's fine. Okay, sorry about that. Terribly sorry, everybody. So, we're back, and... Alright, it looks like... Looks like everything's fine, I guess?
You in?
I'm in. I just wanted to make sure that my spring settings weren't messed up. And it looks okay. Like... No, they're fine. Alright, we're good. Let's continue. My apologies, everyone watching. Occasionally, technical difficulties do happen. So, We have Black Touchy going for gunships with Sigaro going for cloaky bots. No real rushes or anything there. 400 going for planes with a bit of a swift scouting rush. Nothing major, just scouting a bit. And sides! Here we go, something different from Zenfer. Right off the bat, sides. Why not? And it looks like a blastwing rush was completely thwarted by those swifts, which is pretty much what you want to do with a blastwing rush if you're against it. But a second blastwing is able to come in, so a bit of damage will be dealt by Black Duchy. Not a huge amount. But we'll see how that goes. And already, Sigaro coming in very rapidly with more glaives. This is the thing Sigaro does. Bear in mind, Sigaro loves to do this. Set up a bunch of glaives, put them all together, and reveals the scythe too. The scythe rush has been revealed. That's the big thing here. I mean, yeah, okay, no commanders were killed. The last time we saw, Sigaro and Black Judgy were playing against Google Frog, that's how they won, was blow up the commanders, at least in the first game, and Ravaged. So they're probably going for the same strategy this time. I have no confidence it would work. For one thing, 400
ticks by Sigaro.
Hmm?
Sigaro's making ticks for some reason.
Well, probably to bait out the scythes. Like, put the ticks somewhere meaningful. The scythes come in and then the ticks spot them and explode? I mean, if the ticks go off, the scythes are getting stunned. I mean, it makes sense to me. Ticks are a great defensive unit. And actually, the timing will work out nicely too. So the ticks are right there, right on the ramp. That's the idea. Get them on the ramp. That means the scythes cannot easily go through. And at this point, I don't think that Lobster Team has seen it. I don't think Zenfer knows. So Zenfer right now just waiting for a decent opportunity to come in, of which there are none because of that tick. At least not through that ramp. Oh, but the tick! Oh no! Oh wow, that is the worst possible timing! Sigaro repositioning the tick. Oh, I see. Repositioning the tick because another tick's coming in. That's still terrible timing though, because at this point I'm fairly certain Zenfer did see that there was a tick. At least on that one. However, they're also going to run straight into this other tick, which they've also seen. And which they're also avoiding. That did not work.
They managed to get into base.
Yep. Wow, that really bad timing for tick repositioning. Like, that is the worst. That is so unlucky for tick repositioning timing. I mean, at this point, also, there's a bit of skirmishing going on outside, but really, the scythes, they're the main story. Just double-checking first. It looks like, overall, Black Duchy and Sigaro are actually doing a pretty good job taking the center of the map. But these scythes here, doing some damage to Black Duchy's commander. Not much. The tick goes off, stunning both, and not leaving line of sight for the Lotus, but giving enough time to repair Black Duchy's commander, at least. Which actually isn't being repaired all that much. No, it's being repaired a little bit. Actually, it's being repaired quite a lot. So yeah, Black Duchy's commander at least managing to repair itself enough that the scythe, and not that it would have mattered, Black Duchy's commander wasn't a huge amount of risk, but hey, it saved the day. Crowd control enough that...
But 400 is.
Yeah, 400's in a bit of trouble. I don't know. 400, how's your commander you looking? It's a couple rapiers. One more volley, that should do it. But those warriors doing a nice job pushing it out of the way, so I think 400's commander is going to survive. Yeah, that was close. That was a close call, but 400's commander definitely fine. Until Banshees come in. And then it dies. Oh no, still good. Maybe another rapier volley? Maybe. And they're trying, I mean, Southwest has learned. Black Duchy and Sigaro have learned. Go for the commanders. Go for the commanders that's
3%.
Done. Oh! No available volleys! The rapiers need to hold fire at this point. Just wait until they see the whites of the commander's eyes and then shoot. That commander, so close to being dead. Setting up a bot plant, or setting up an amphib plant. So that's the switch off. That's the ground switch for 400. Not sure what that's going to happen. I mean, the thing is that we do have Cloaky, and of course, Glaive versus Duck is a win for Duck. Boys don't do especially well against... No, rapiers... I think it was rapiers don't do well against boys. Can't remember which way it goes. But yeah, leaving that commander alive, that's still a problem. That is not something that they want. Lobster team getting a lot from reclaim as a result. I mean, a lot from reclaim. All that, well, not all that, but 12 of that was that commander. So yeah, if a good shot could be taken in there, like one good shot at the commander could be taken, that would do the trick. But it looks like that commander is relatively safe, so Zagato and Black Touchy having to play the long game today, or at least in this round. And they are falling behind economically. They do have a decent control of the map's center, but they don't have a whole lot of expansion. Do have a Wasp going around, do have a Conjurer going around, so a bit of expansion. But yeah, it's fine. I mean, the thing is, it's just... You know, setting up the early thing, just setting up all the stuff for your basic map control. That's the important thing. Is you want to have that map control, you want to have it early, and you want to maintain it. Southwest has that early map control, so it's just a matter of expanding, just a matter of really taking advantage of that. Also, yeah. Southwest has... Sorry, go on.
And the thing is here, at the moment, Sagero and Black Duchy have infinitely better, I would have to say, map mobility. They can get across the map much faster.
Yes. Totally. Yeah, the Glaives can't do a whole lot unless the Warriors are out of position. But the Warriors are currently out of position, so that's exactly the right point. Same with the Gremlins and the Rapiers. Like, Southwest, they may not have the economic advantage entirely, but they've got the initiative. Excuse me. So yeah, they've... At this point, Southwest can pick the fights, however they choose. Although I'm not sure if that's going to last forever. It looks like that's actually becoming rather difficult. Bit of damage being dealt. A couple of glaives fell down, but... Yeah, a bit of damage being dealt, but the Blastwing not able to do a whole lot. And at this point, Lobster managing to apply pressure. And most of the units you're talking about, they're now dead. The ones for the initiative. At the same time, though, very heavy Blastwing attack in the main base just to try to shut down production, but the main production is from this Amphib plant. Everything hit there. There was some power that was damaged, but nothing really meaningful. The only problem, of course, is for reclaim, but yeah... That's the thing. However, Southwest now getting the economic advantage. Now that Lobster no longer has reclaim, Southwest has the economic advantage, has the production to deal with the economic advantage. And it's just a matter of dealing with all these warriors. As soon as the warriors go down, Southwest is going to be able to retake an advantage very rapidly. It's not going to be hard at all.
Yeah. And Self currently has about a 20 metal per second advantage over Dwarf, so...
Mm-hmm. Exactly. And now that the army's out of the way, that advantage can really come up and really become useful. More Blastwings in here. More dead everything. Well, mostly dead wind generators. That's about it.
I don't see a brawler.
I don't see any. I mean, there's one in the queue. That'll be a little wild yet. Oh, never mind, there's already one constructed. My mistake. Yes, you're right, there is in fact one brawler. There is a brawler, and there will be a second brawler fairly shortly after the tridents are built up. Good choice. These warriors are not going to be able to deal with that, and even the gremlins have a bit of a hard time focusing it down. I mean, it's not impossible, but at the same time... there's the scythe. I was wondering, where's that? There's a scythe there. There is a scythe there, getting rid of the air factory, and nothing can be done about it. That air plant's dead. Four more hits, three more hits, two more hits, one more hit, there we go! Factory's down to the cost of the scythe, but hey, that's... Not sure if that's worth it, actually. Commander's also down, though! I missed that. That also blew up recently. Okay, a lot of damage dealt to the Lobster team. A lot of damage. Southwest with a very strong start. Like, as in, start of the finals. Like, this is game one. That'll probably be theirs. Black Judgy adding in shield. That's the ground switch. And it looks like overall, I mean, I don't know. Lobster is starting to really gain some territory here. This north interior side here, that's given them a lot, and their raids are now becoming very fruitful. So while I would say that Southwest is still ahead, it's evening out pretty quick. Black Duchy probably going to go for Racketeers to get rid of the boys and possibly also to get rid of the Warriors. But at this point, Southwest, they're losing a lot of territory. They're losing a lot of map control. And, okay, there's no more planes coming in, so no, say, Thunderbirds. Admittedly, that was Hokomoko's thing more than anybody. But still, none of that, sure. This is still going to be an uphill struggle. Southwest, they need to get rid of the Warriors. If they get rid of the Warriors, then they should be able to retake territory. If not, then they're kind of hooped. Looks like they have both their commanders, though, at least. That's one thing. Even if their commander's not in the front lines like Zenfer is, they still have him. Wow, that's a lot of hammers. That is a lot.
It is.
I mean, okay, there's defenses. Yes, there's a couple of defenders, but that's a lot of hammers. I think they've been building them pretty much, not that nonstop, but yeah, they've been building them instead of Rocco's, which I find a bizarre choice. I don't really understand, but at the same time, the Southeast has been retaken at least, and it does help with defenders, if nothing else. And at least it doesn't get rid of the Warriors, but it gets rid of the Metal Extractor, so there's some damage dealt. It's not nothing. It'll be much more useful against the Stinger, assuming they survive that long. And, okay, I mean, Glaives can beat Warriors, that's not impossible, but that was a very bizarre way of doing things. Regardless, the Warriors are down. One's down, the other one's gonna take pretty heavy fire. The Hammer Fire is still meaningful enough. And nice Warrior there. Okay, that was good. That worked out nicely. Beating the Hammers, Zeus and Racketeer. Bit of overkill, but it worked.
With these hammers, Southwest finally being able to retake their share of the map and possibly push into the Eversai.
I think they will. And look at the assets. You have four boys here. You have a couple warriors, mostly gremlins. I mean, there's some archers being built up, which that's handy, but there's only two or six. Six? Really? Oh, I see. A bunch of them are harassing the Southeast. I mean, there's some harassment forces, some forces around the map a bit. Mostly static defenses, and, well, we have an entire army of hammers. So, static defenses are kind of worthless. At this point, I would say that Southwest is still doing very strong just by composition. I mean, their economy is also strong, which is good. But composition alone, they're ahead. And now we have Hammer Wars, which will be won by the Southwest team because Glaives exist. For the Southwest team, not for the Northeast team, not the Lobster, just for the Southwest team. And at this point, Southwest team just setting up everything, just getting everything together. And we do have Racketeers. I called that right. But yeah, there's Lobster is desperately trying to essentially win small skirmishes. I mean, they have the economic fight kind of won. It's just, I feel like Lobster's trying to win small skirmishes without actually getting into a good position and taking territory. It's defensive. Unfortunately, the Hammers are, for the Hammers at least, they're going down fast. These archers taking on most of the Hammers here. Seven left, but still, that is not healthy. The Stinger is the main target. That's the thing the Hammers need to be used for. Everything else is kind of icing on the cake. That was handy, it was a thing, but no, you want to save that for the Stinger. Oh, I see. Right, yeah. Really? Apparently the metagame has shifted so that the Hammers are now essentially the Rocco equivalent. I was not aware of that, because I'm never on when matchmaking is actually being used, if matchmaking is ever used. So, yeah, that's been bugging me. Anyway. While that's apparently a thing, Lobster pushing in with a bunch of ducks. I mean, a lot of that force is Hammers. The ducks would deal with that. There are some bandits in place. There's no warriors, though. There's no, I guess, outlaws. Nothing really to deal with ducks right now. I mean, there are rapiers, though. That does exist. So it is something. That was a lot of dead convicts. Oh, no, those are ducks, not convicts. What am I saying? I'm out of it today. A lot of dead ducks, though. So the rapiers are doing their job. And Southwest still maintaining. It's just economic advantage is kind of going back and forth. Neither team really has a solid lead right now. Southwest had one, but they've lost it. And Lobster turning what they can into ducks, but now getting the grizzly, that is super risky. I don't think the timing will work out at all.
And especially since there's just so much stuff on the field right now that can outrange it. Because they can just spam hammers back.
Spam hammers, spam Roccos, spam rogues, racketeers. There's already, how many racketeers are here? There's three racketeers already. Like, a grizzly wouldn't last that long. I'm a bit surprised at the choice. I feel like it's only being done because that's what you do. Like, that's the done thing with Amphib. I just don't see it being especially effective in this case. Not sure really what Amphib could do in this case, but I feel like grizzlies just because you're getting into late game, and it's like, well, I guess you should do that. The archers have been working out nicely, though, so I don't know. Like, archer-duck mix, I almost feel like would be the way to go. Just, it's a bit risky, but it's the only thing I think that Amphib could do. Any other option just seems, well, impossible. Especially not grizzly. Anyway. Southwest now with a 20 metal per second.
And grizzly is done.
It is. The question is whether or not it'll actually do anything now that it's done. Because that seems unlikely. The sheer number of rogues on top of the Zeus. Well, the Zeuses are going to be the hardest hit by the grizzly, but everything else. So many things outranging it. So many things that'll deal with heavy units, no problem. No real fallback, because it's fighting right next to its main base. And, of course, everything else getting harassed along the side as well. I mean, bandits coming along to the northwest, rapiers along the southeast, or south center, or east center, rather. And the grizzly, few racketeer strikes, probably another five or six racketeer strikes away from, no, three racketeer strikes, I'd say. And it's completely out. Forced out of the fight. Nowhere it can really safely go. I mean, at this point, the real bastion of any significance is over to the west center interior. Like, the northwest center interior is the only thing that's really built up in a way that's going to be difficult to deal with. And that's where Lobster's getting a lot of its money from. That and the overdrive that's leading to and from it. Otherwise, there isn't much that they have. The southwest has pretty much got all the territory. Grizzly's out of the fight. Most of the amphib units are out of the fight. Most of the units are out of the fight. Does Lobster even have an army anymore? It looks like they basically don't. They have a commander. Everything else is getting just locked into a racketeer hell. And anglers. Oh, a valiant effort, but not gonna work. I mean, it worked a little bit. Obviously, it killed some rapiers. It's not terrible, it's just, it's not gonna work in the end. And Blastwing's coming in to just burn up the rest. Ooh, getting actually hit pretty hard. Anglers worked out pretty well that case. That saved a lot of damage. I think only one metal extractor was destroyed compared to basically everything. So hey, that's something. The anglers weren't completely useless. Anyway.
That grizzly's getting a little too close to dying.
Sorry?
The grizzly's probably gonna die in about the next 3 minutes.
Well, I think it's really just more that it's not doing anything. It doesn't matter if it lives or dies. It's dead right now. It's not doing anything. It's not. It's barely dealing any damage. It's basically been a metal sink. It's now starting to get a little bit of damage in, but with all the hammers set up. Yeah, I don't know. It just has to retreat. It has to stay out of the way. It has to stay out of the fight. Otherwise, it's going to die. It's just not doing anything right now. That's the problem. Ooh, but a Spectre coming in here to try to get rid of possibly hammer, one hammer at a time. That's the idea, at least. But the hammer's... No, the hammer's gonna hit it. I mean, it just got... Just got killed in one shot. Okay, never mind. All that buildup about the Spectre, completely pointless. Just got wiped
out. And Zenfer's comma's gonna go down.
Oh yeah, there it is. Zenfer's commander getting hit by that last rapier shot, so there it goes. And that's... Well, I mean, the southeast is still a bit of a problem, but this northwest, basically just a matter of time. It's just going to be torn apart gradually. A couple specters, tearing, a couple rapiers, a couple Zeus. Okay, one Zeus, the other just died, but still, it's done. The northwest is just going to be torn apart bit by bit. The southeast is the only real contentious point, and even then, it's just a matter of time, because everything's getting racketeered. Nothing is staying active long enough, armed long enough, to actually deal with anything. The only downside is, as we can see, Black Duchy's not really paying attention to the western side of the map, so this rapier just sort of getting killed. Like, it's just sitting there as it's getting shot. It was kind of sick of life, I guess. That's sad. That's depressing. And Zenfer realizing, yeah, this is over. This one's over. Move on to the next one. Pick a better map. Four? Really? 400, what? Doing an air switch. Okay.
Blastwing Rush is coming in.
It's not a rush at this point, just a Blastwing Assault. But yes. Otherwise, you are correct. And once again, not dealing a huge amount of damage. But once again, it doesn't really matter, because that's not where the damage mainly gets dealt. I mean, really, the Northwest... There is that final push to get rid of the Northwest, or just about... Never mind, the bandits didn't survive long enough. Spectre should be able to finish this off, though. And while the Northeast is still in contention, it's not by much. It really is not by much. Southwest with such an overwhelming economic advantage, there, I don't really know what the Northeast expects. I mean, this air switch, that's going to take almost a minute to set up. I mean, it's going to take a minute and a half in total to set up. I don't understand what the logic is there. I feel like it'd be far better for Lobster just to call it, pick a better map for them, win the next game, make it 1-1, not sure if it's best of 5 or best of 3, and then work back from there rather than burning their energy on this game. Even if they win this game, just given how much of an uphill struggle it's been, they'll probably not have the energy to play the rest of their rounds well. And I don't think they're going to win this game. It would be very surprising if they won this game, just given the position they're in, given the fact that their main source of army is done, it's out of the fight, and there we go. Nope, 400 and Zenfer do not agree on whether or not, what is, 400's going for a bunch of phoenixes. I can kind of see that maybe dealing with a bit of the rogues, but it's not the fact that there are so many rogues, it's the fact that there are so many rogues in production, being produced remarkably quickly. And actually, this is the slow part. This is a bad time to show it. But they still can be produced remarkably quickly. Like, I don't see any traps. I don't see any tricks. I don't see anything that's here that's gonna make it not end. Sigeto pointing out the need for a strider, sure, but really, doesn't even matter. And okay, there's the phoenixes doing their thing, but that's not gonna work. There's just too much of an army, and now the grizzly's dead.
Die.
Goodbye, grizzly. And oh, okay, apparently planning to go for a Dante drop. Frankly, I don't think the game will last that long, but if it does, that will definitely close it out. And I just realized the effect of the whole delay, the chat delay, because Lori just mentioning, man, if the grizzly doesn't die, North has a chance. 30 seconds after the grizzly died in real time, but because of the delay, they won't know until
yeah,
a couple minutes later. But yeah, that's the game. Well, that's the first match. 400 and Zenfer could still come back. They could go for Red Common again and do a really good job like they did last time. Although I feel like Sigeru and Black Duchy, they've they're solid. I mean, Seguero alone, unit value for Seguero in particular was highest. Energy income was highest, metal income was highest. Seguero, between the two of them, Seguero is definitely pulling a lot of the weight. They're both doing a good job, but it's like, I know I haven't seen a lot of Seguero, but man, Seguero is, well, I wouldn't say carrying, but Seguero is doing, is putting in work. They're both Seguero and Black Dutch are putting in work. This is not being carried by either player. This is a team. So, now that game one has been played, we'll see what game two gives us. I am assuming Red Comet, but we'll see. I can only assume. Yes, I know. Silly crash. And it is Red Comet. I guessed correctly. Alright, so, Red Comet. I'm guessing probably going to see another setup with hovercraft and light vehicles like last time. Right. Red Comet.
Well, that's weird.
You have to use two asterisks in 0K lobby. I mean, yeah. Sorry, asterisks. Ampersands.
Okay.
Anyway. With that, we are on to Red Comet, so I'm guessing... I'm guessing this is just going to be 1-1, and then we'll move on to game 3, and then who knows what will happen. I would be very surprised if it was a 2-0 at this point. But if it is, good job to Black Dutch and Seguero. And well, I haven't seen a Cube one in a while.
Have you guys actually seen Orchard Rush this tournament?
Nope, not me. Well, there's the Monaco references. That's been a while. Cube hasn't actually played in, like, months. I missed that guy. Anyway. And no, I don't wish that Cube would play. There are better things to use your wishes on. So anyway. Seguero and Black Dutchy... Life Eagle Hover, that's pretty typical. Nothing out of the ordinary. 400 and Zenfer, I'm really curious about them. Looks like Black Dutchy and Seguero, they're playing pretty typical. They're playing pretty standard, safe, strong play. They've had the rushes, sort of, in the Ravage game, but that's just really raids that were very successful.
Yeah.
In this case, though, I don't know. And did something go wrong with this? I feel like... Nope. Zenfer and 400, they're on the same side. There was a bit of a weird thing in the lobby where it looked like 400 was the only player on team 2. But anyway.
Okay.
We are good, so get that set up. And it looks like 400 and Zenfer are just going to do the same thing they did against Google Frog and Orphelius. It wasn't against those two. It was against the other two. It was against Anakin and Hokomoko. That's what they did against. My mistake. So Black Dutchy, so light vehicles for Seguero and Black Dutchy is going for tanks. Well, on the other hand, we have light vehicles for 400 and hovercraft for Zenfer, doing apparently the same thing they did last time, which unfortunately we only saw the final few minutes of. This time we can see it from the beginning. And
it may actually get Scorch Rush.
Oh, where? Oh, 400 going for it. Yeah, they've got the four Scorchers. That's the thing.
Seguero sort of is too.
Well, yeah. Not as quickly. At the same time, though, the Panthers are coming in. Panthers and Kodachis are coming in, so that's going to be a matter of timing and positioning, I think. I feel like it's going to almost be a base trade. I wouldn't be surprised if this game just came down to like some weird tactical thing that became a base trade that ended up just getting out of hand. That seems like what'll happen. Oh, you haven't seen Modica Magica, have you? I think you're old enough.
Like, one of the few animes I haven't watched, probably.
Aw, it's one of my favorite shows. Like, I think it's second to Fate Zero for me. And that's only because Fate Zero has a better world building. Like, the actual story and delivery is far better in Modica. It's just Fate Zero has more complete world building, and I value that a lot. Anime aside, looks like 400 Scorchrush kind of out of the way. Very out of the way. Wants to dodge everything. But that's really going to be the question. I mean, at this point, first blood drawn by Black Duchy, or at least first damage by Black Duchy. Closing down the Light Vehicle Factory, though it's a little late for that, but still, the important thing is scouting it out. The fact that the Light Vehicle Factory is doing nothing is a pretty good hint as to what's going to happen. Sugiro, however, does not have their own score. I mean, they have a couple Scorchers, but really it's a numbers game, and the numbers are in the favor of 400. Especially when they're that close together. When the numbers are that close together. When the units as well are that close together. And at this point, some decent rating, not really a whole lot of damage. I mean, at this point, West Team is way ahead economically, that's the one thing. And Panthers as well. Panthers, they do a pretty good job against Scorchers. Actually, at this point, these Scorchers are basically doing nothing. Black Duchy's commander is fine. Sugiro took a bit of damage, lost a couple Scorchers, but honestly, nothing meaningful. Really, the West Team got an advantage out of that. They got a lot out of that. Got good reclaim, too, and economically, they're way ahead. So, those Panthers as well, but really, the Panthers didn't do much. They were a good idea. They help. But that whole rush just didn't really accomplish anything. The commanders were behind too much defenses. They had just enough units to keep them alive. I mean, look, three Lotuses for both. Or for each, rather, on the western side. And Lobster had no way in from there. And now Sugiro going for the counter rush. Getting rid of a worker. Nice and effective. Yeah, Quill's gone. Not going to deal with the commander, but that's fine. Got rid of the Quill, which is good. Although, that was a lot of damage to the commander. One more Scorcher, and that would have actually done the trick. Wow, that's got to be painful.
Yeah.
Sugiro almost had that one. Still, Western team taking some damage. Looks like 400 hasn't given up yet, but that Scorcher's going to die. Panthers should be able to intercept it. This one over here to the south should intercept it, no problem. And like I said, there's so many static defenses, there's not an easy way of dealing with that. The one problem, of course, is the continuous raiding along the northwest side. At this point, the Western team hasn't taken it, but when they do, that will be a problem. Anyway, Zenfer just reclaiming a little bit from that. It's kind of unfortunate, though. I mean, that Quill, that's meaningful damage. So it's not totally unfortunate. That does slow down the northward expansion from the Lobster team. So West will be able to... they gotta expand, though! And this is one big thing Black Duchy needs to get, and they have a welder now, finally. But they need to expand along the south side. Because that is not doing them any favors. What? Oh, I think Sortail's asking me if I watched a show that I haven't watched. Anyway.
Oh.
Like, seriously, I can count the number of anime I've watched in two hands. I don't watch a whole lot of them. I probably will watch more, given that I have housemates now who are much more into it than I am, but yeah, I haven't really watched a whole lot of series. Anyway, nice hold indeed. That halberd there, Lori can't point that halberd. That's a different halberd. I don't know what they're pointing out the hold for. That might be... No, they're not watching the game, they're watching through the stream. Okay, they're talking about something different. There was actually a nice hold. The whole fire on this halberd, though, is still impressive, though. It's good technique from Zenfer. However, I think that Lori was talking about the fact that the West team held, and now she also... Both teams have been holding. Early pressure from Scorchers hasn't really gotten through to either one, though Lobster way ahead economically. That welder taking forever. Oh, well, okay, it's not the only one, but still, that Lobster... That welder taking a while to build up and do anything. There are other welders, but the problem is more so the south side hasn't been expanded to. That is the thing. It's just The West is getting so behind economically because of that lack of an expansion. Sekiro's going fine. Yeah, Sekiro's doing absolutely fine. It's Black Duchy that's actually having no expansion right now. That's been the problem. Black Duchy should be able to make that up pretty quick, but it will take a little while. They'll need an economic advantage for a couple minutes to get back the advantage they had. Good efficient use of the Panthers, though. Getting rid of the Slashers will help when it comes to the economic advantage. And now there's the raids. There's the attacks. Stardust almost done. Although Panther, it's got the lightning guns. The Stardust, it's going to start out stunned? It's going to start out stunned. Doesn't deal any... Oh, it does deal a bit of damage. There we go. Well, Panther takes some damage, but 400's Commander. 400's Commander in a really bad spot. Black Duchy, they may not have been expanding, but holy crap, that is some harassment going on there. 400 no longer able to expand safely in the south side. Brilliantly done. Black Duchy. Black Duchy basically turning the economy into an attack. That's a way to hold the team. So Sagero's on all the economy. Black Duchy's on all the harassment. Zenfer's on that pause button. Because apparently their lag is beyond horrible. Three seconds of lag. Wow, okay. Yeah. Not sure how that's gonna work out. I feel like that's possibly just not gonna be tenable. At any rate, Western team does seem to be in a relatively good position, especially if Zenfer resigns, but overall does seem to be... Black Duchy's harassment will be able to get rid of about another 10 metal per second, which will decisively swing the economy into West team's favor. However, Sekiro taking some hits. Shouldn't be too hard, but this...
And if those Panthers get into the back of the base, that's going to deal quite a bit of damage.
Oh, and there's only one Lotus. The levelers will be a problem, though. Levelers counter Panthers. Like, straight up counter Panthers. So there isn't really any easy way of dealing with that. Nice Wolverines, though. And overall, I mean, still deals some damage. I mean, these Panthers are still doing work. Did a lot of work. That's, like I said, swung the economy down. West team with 10 metal per second advantage. The levelers will be able to deal with this, although all that Lotus goes down, that's still a big deal. I don't know if it will. I feel like it's not going to. Oh, got stunned. That's something, but no, it's not even the target. Like, the reason I'm saying get that stunned is that, or killed rather, is you open it up to whatever else comes in. It doesn't have to be Panthers. It doesn't have to be strong enough to take it. It just goes past and deals with more damage. Goes around the back of the base.
Yeah.
And with that, pressure's been taken off of Sekiro, so Sekiro has a chance to rebuild. Actually has a chance to harass. Taking Zenfer out, because Zenfer has to deal with all this pressure coming in from Black Duchy. So that's working out very nicely. I mean, this overall, that was a very good move by Black Duchy. That gave the West team back the game. However, Sekiro, I mean, they're basically going kind of slow. There's enough repair, it seems, that it's not going to make a big difference. The mines, they aren't coming in frequently enough to really matter yet. There needs to be far more of them. Or just don't even bother with mines and come in with something much more powerful. Like, come in with a bunch of ravagers. Just tear down everything. At the same time, though, leveler scalpel, which is pretty much the counter combination for Panther, so... Right now, Reapers could work, Banishers might work, and that's exactly what Black Duchy's going for, Reaper Banisher. Pillager would also work, but that'd be a little bit difficult. That'd be hard from an economic perspective. And West Team starting to lose some of their economic edge. I mean, it was good to have harassment, but now Lobster retaking those metal extractors, as they should. Very good choice. But the Banisher's up. First Banisher's up. The Reaper should be up in about half a minute. Okay, that's not going to be relevant for a while. Not for this battle. It's going to be another battle fairly soon. And the Scorch is coming in to get rid of the Scalpels. Nicely done. So the Scalpels are gone. That'll give the Panther some room to breathe, but at this point, that's kind of irrelevant. Still, it's good to have. And the Banisher doing his job, more harassment coming in, more damage coming in, Lobster team losing more economy, and Western team with so much reclaim that they're way ahead economically. Like, way ahead, entirely because of reclaim. But yeah, that is a big deal. So at this point...
And Black Duchy just sort of needs something to do with all those levelers.
That is the main problem, yes. I mean, the Banisher's not a bad idea. The Reaper is going to be very effective. But yeah, for the time being, it's just... Oh man, how do you deal with that, right? Like, not with Panthers, that's for sure. Not with Scorchers either. They both lose. The Reaper should be okay. Yeah, the Reaper's fine. That's the thing. You, like, levelers, they're about the splash, they're about the heavy damage. They're not really... Well, somewhat heavy damage. Mostly about the splash. I actually don't know. They only deal 200 damage every shot, so they don't deal a huge amount of damage. They just spread it among everything. So they actually usually need a lot of them to deal with large groups of units. Oh, those welders. Oh, good, they're repairing the Reaper. That's exactly what they need to repair. The slashes will be able to do no meaningful damage here. And Sigero still holding that line. Could probably build a couple more metal extractors, but overall holding that line. And the welders are up front as well in the south side, so... this point, Black Duchy can rebuild that too. Lobster does have the economic advantage at the moment, but overall, and this is the same defensive line. And now the counter push to get rid of the Wolverines, or try to get rid of the Wolverines. I mean, the Halberds are really the problem here. Although, admittedly, Wolverines with Stinger, that's an interesting combination, and it's working out nicely. Like, Wolverines to bait and then the Stinger to finish him off. And at this point, it looks like we're back to a bit of a stalemate-y situation. Gunship's coming up for 400, so probably see brawlers, I'm guessing. Makes sense.
Yeah.
Anyway. And brawlers coming up. A lot of dugout metal extractors now, too. Doesn't make a lot of sense with all the Wolverines going around, but okay. Wolverines and Impalers, because why not? If you have more than one artillery type, I guess it's better than just having one artillery type. That makes a lot of sense. Anyway. Looks like we're going to be seeing...
Elbert's up top.
Close, yeah. Lobster's coming in on the top. Zenfer with a nice little halberd attack here. Not a whole lot to deal with it either. This is actually going to be able to do a lot of damage. This could very well do for Lobster what Black Duchy's attack did for the Western team. It's opening up the north, and there's not a whole lot of defenses on the north side. I don't see any Striders coming up either. Looks like most of the metal is going into making Banisher Reaper, which admittedly is a really good pushing combo. It's just not the best defensive combo. I feel like the only defense that West team has right now is essentially putting so much pressure on Lobster that Lobster is forced to pull away from this halberd attack.
Yeah.
Or if they do the halberd attack as a Pyrrhic victory. Like, yeah, sure, they kill things, but they lose the entire base because those halberds were out of position, and then everything else is dead. Although, unfortunately for Zenfer, their commander's down too. Zenfer's commander dropped. I missed that. Sorry about that. Yeah, Zenfer's commander is down, so that expansion is very much, much more difficult. As well, all the halberds going down too. Scorcher's dealing with them no problem, so overall, West team is holding on very tightly. Some repairs are needed here, but yeah, this Reaper Banisher pair, that's exactly... Well, it didn't even so much that, it was just Scorcher's came in to save the day. But the Reaper Banisher pair on top of that. And here's the payoff for the gunships. Banshees. Loads and loads of Banshees. 400
with...
This could
be GG.
Because of the Banshees, you think?
Yeah.
Yeah, they don't really have any anti-air, do they? They have crashers, though. They just got rapid crashers. And I think that's more than enough crashers. Like, these Banshees are going to be completely thinned out. That's already half of them down. Another half of that half, like, yeah, they're down to a quarter of their original number. And Black Duchy with this, the thing is, you're dealing with 50 metal per second, so even something like this, it's a bit surprising. There's not enough that it's going to be able to kill them.
Lag for 10 seconds.
Sheesh. Oh, I see. Zenfer's trying to get 400 to do all the really combat stuff. That's a good way of doing it. But yeah, that... Oh, man. That Banshee setup. I mean, the Crashers, like I said, you can just rebuild. You can build up an army. It's like, oh, they're doing something. Build a response. And unless their initial attack was overwhelming, your response will be up in time. It's not like if it was 20, 30 metal per second. If that was the case and he had to switch, which is oftentimes when it's the switch in smaller maps or less economic maps or in 1v1, yeah, at that point it can be devastating. But no, they spotted it and just went. It was a reaction. They might have called it a little bit, but they didn't build that many Crashers. It looks like it was purely reaction. And that was more than enough. So at this point, I don't know, the heavy tank numbers have thinned out as well. Decent reclaim coming in for the Western team, though, so this should be fine, but mostly they're switching to air, and I think it's Black Duchy switching to air, just in case more Banshees come, and there will be Blast Wings, not necessarily more Banshees. Maybe. It's not clear. Definitely Blast Wings, though, and that Penetrator's now up, so.
Tons of Banishers north. Actually, south.
Yeah. Yeah, Southside Banishers are pretty much the only thing that's there. And there's one Reaper and three Banishers. So the south side being held pretty well, but the problem is there's not a whole lot being built up. Black Duchy hasn't built a lot of metal extractors. I mean, it's kind of the difference between Lobster and West Team right now is that, and in general it seems, Lobster is perfectly willing to build in a hot conflict zone. They're just digging him into the ground. Whereas West Team, or at least Black Duchy, seems very reluctant. They're almost feel like they're trying to set up a strong defensive line that they know they can hold for a minute or two and have held for a minute or two before setting up expansions, even though it only takes 30 seconds for them to pay for themselves at plus 2. And just slightly less at plus 2.3. So if they can hold it for a minute, they've paid for the metal extractor double. Like, they've profited quite a lot. And more scalpels coming in, that's... There's so many scalpels that even, I mean, yeah, it's not a bad idea. Oh, there we go. There's the Phoenix. It was mentioned in the chat logs. Phoenix for the scalpels. The Reaper doesn't have much of a chance. Oh, it's more so the Penetrator. That's the problem. Well, that's fine. Just build some Ravens and then it's done. But I feel like Lobster Team is going to be just setting up... I'll set up the anti-air already in advance. Just making sure the Penetrator can't be bombed out. Because that's what you do. Like, two Ravens, take out a Penetrator. That's value. That's loads of value compared to the damage it can deal. My Penetrator deals so much flipping damage. It's apparently perfectly silent, but it deals a lot of damage nonetheless. And now the south side, open up! It's totally open for the Lobster Team. I mean, some damage can be dealt. Oh, but never mind, the Penetrator's...
Ace.
Ooh, Penetrator's so close to getting hit. So close. Didn't quite manage, though. And Trident's going down, and more damage being dealt. This... Now, that Penetrator is managing to get out of the way, but it is really the main force holding this outside. Like, if that Penetrator were to go down, this outside would fall, and I think that'd be game. It's just the Penetrator's continued existence is keeping this outside safe. Or at least this outside blue. But I'm pretty sure that Lobster Team is going to lose it pretty soon. Actually, no. They're retreating decently enough. They should be fine. But at the same time, they're not holding the south side, so the south side could just fall. And actually, Kodachi's coming in here to get rid of the Slashers, which should be effective. Should be very effective. Two or three down for, like, no losses? That's nice. That's what you want to see. At least if you're playing the Kodachis. And more Phoenix is coming in as well. There's not really much of a counterforce. I mean, Zenfer with a shield bot factory, but I guess they're not using it due to the lag. And Trident's being streamed out of 400's factory, but 400 not really able to keep them alive thanks to the Hawks. And there goes the Penetrator! Gone down thanks to an Impaler. That's basically it. The south side is wide open now. There are some Scorchers, but their life is short. They are not long for this world. And while the south side is still being desperately held on to, I mean, Lobster does have the economic advantage. That Reclaim is giving them the advantage. That is something which, like, West team needs to do, is bring in... They have welders. They have the toughest workers in the game. They need to bring them in and start using them to build up. Assuming they have welders. I mean, I feel like that's the thing. Ugh, it's such a... It's kind of a thing that's a bit of a different... It's a skill marker in this game, is being confident enough to be in the midst of a battle reclaiming. And it's the difference between good players and great players. And that's what's giving Lobster the edge right now. Well, it's one of the differences. Rebuilding mechs regularly is another big difference. So I feel like West Team is fighting an uphill battle just because they aren't reclaiming when they could be. And aren't burning the reclaimers either. So yeah, if these were all set on fire, then West Team would basically, be back to parity, but in a much better position at least. Right now they're not on fire, and there's a lot of reclaim they're taking. How many thousands of metal reclaim? 6,000 metal reclaim, actually, in the circle they're in, 5,000 metal reclaim. What? Yeah, 5,000 metal, and nothing is being done about it.
Yeah.
And they have 30 metal per second bonus as a result. That is such a big deal. I mean, it's the damage that's being dealt. It's like phoenixes. You have phoenixes. You have the perfect unit to just wipe all this out. And it's not being done. Like, I don't understand why. I mean, granted, all the Scorchers are basically wasted money at this point, but it's like, it's so disappointing that the reclaim is not being taken as seriously as it needs to be. Because that's the thing that's giving Lobster an economic edge. And that's the only thing. And that's allowing them to... That's letting them afford all these Scorchers that are dying. So I don't really see... Like, all this reclaim's gonna go. And, okay, now the levelers are in, that'll at least deal with it. It's just, it could have been dealt with minutes ago. Could have been dealt with, like... And remember, that's plus 30 metal per second. So they could have been dealt with, like, 4,000 metal ago, roughly. How much is that? Yeah, I'd say roughly 4,000 metal ago. Yeah, that's a lot of metal that Lobster got from that.
Shigeru, calm down.
Oh, what?
Oh, Penetrator dead too.
Oh, Penetrator died a while ago. I pointed that out.
There's another one that just died.
Hmm? Oh, another? Really? Ouch.
And it killed Sigaro's Tom before dying.
Oh. I missed that. I was very focused on the south side, where things were just finishing up. Didn't quite notice that there was, in fact, a dead commander. And with that, Sigaro's gonna have a bit of a hard time expanding. Yeah, there it goes. It's done. It is dead. That is a fair point.
And now there's about 9,000 flame.
Hmm? Yes, yeah.
There's about 9,000 metal worth of reclaim.
Which will now be in the hands of the West team. It kind of sucks that Zenfer's having these lag issues. I feel like Lobster would be winning hands down if it weren't for that, which I don't want to say because it's like, I don't feel like the West team is doing a bad job. It's just, there's a lot of little things that West team is not doing or taking into account or taking advantage of that. I think if it weren't for the fact that Zenfer can't play effectively and is essentially relying on 400 to do all the micromanagement, that Zenfer would probably, that Lobster team would probably have won by now.
Yeah.
Because it is effectively it's kind of a 1v2 combat-wise. Although on the other hand, Lobster team is also going for a lot of units that are basically being hard countered. Like a lot of Scorchers and Slashers and all this other stuff, where the units, there's a bunch of phoenixes in the air. There's nothing that won't work. That phase is done. Build striders or build crows or build, I don't know, I guess more penetrators.
Something.
Something that's heavy enough to deal with the phoenixes. That's the word. Like something that'll deal with the phoenixes, something that'll deal with all this crap that is being thrown at them by the Western team. And now the Western team with the reclaim, now they're getting the advantage, because, I mean, it's already parity, so it's just a matter of who has all the reclaim. And at this point, it is West. Of course, at this point, it's also going to be very difficult. It's also proving to be rather difficult to deal with the North side. The South side is okay, but the North side is very porked up. There's no easy getting into that. And given that the Lobster team is going for Striders and the West team is not going for Striders, I mean, yeah, West team has a bit of an advantage right now money-wise, but I guess if they go for lots of Reapers, that'll kind of do the trick. That's something. But that's their main option right now, is loads of Reapers. Otherwise, it's not really going to work. And Dante being built up. Minute left before Dante, and that might turn the tables again. Oh, hey, look at that.
This game has just been back and forth.
Yes, it has. Yeah. And spectators pointing out that Goliath would be a rather handy counter for the Dante.
And the time rule may invoke soon.
May. Not sure who's winning, though. Very close.
Yeah.
Mind you, that's your job, not mine. Anyway. Or Swordtail's job, I guess, because Swordtail would be in here. Still 5 minutes left before we start getting to time rule stuff. And Dante's been scouted out, so we could see a Goliath coming up. And we don't. At least not immediately. But yes. Dante's been scouted out. We'll see what Black Duchy does. We'll see what Sigero does. Sigero just going straight for Ravagers. Black Duchy, no real indication. Don't see any Goliaths or anything. They could easily build Goliaths, but I don't see any. Looks like they're just assuming Mass Reaper will work. And it might. I mean, that's still a lot of damage, but at the same time, man, Dante deals so much damage that the lighter weight of the, and I mean, relatively lighter weight of the Reapers might not be enough. But that's the idea, Reaper Ball. Reaper Ball all day. Of which there are about four in the front lines. But deal with the Dante directly. The Dante, does it have his D-gun back? It does. And the Reaper's finally now in range, getting torched by that D-gun. Well, Dante's taking a decent amount of damage, but it looks like it's not going to be enough. Those Reapers are all going to go down. And the Welders, okay, seriously? You're fighting with Welders? Yes, okay, yeah, drop Stinger makes some sense. But yeah, what?
But Dante almost died, though.
Dante did almost die, yes. It's just all the Reapers died. That's not value. The Dante is worth 4,000. The Reapers are each worth 800, almost 1,000. So, yeah, that was efficient. And the Dante's not dead. It's getting repaired. It might as well have not been hit at all. Unless there's an attack right now. Like, it opens up a timing window, but that's about it. Granted, West team does seem to be taking advantage of said timing window. They are attacking pretty hard. So, it could still do the trick. It could still be the thing that makes this game go West's favor. Or go anyone's favor. And the Dante moving forward again. But now against Racketeers. I mean, with Racketeers, sorry. It's the Reapers that are against Racketeers and cannot do anything. So yeah, Dante's still holding strong. And the Stinger's doing okay. Ooh, nice. Trying to break the defensive wall of Solar Collectors over to the north side. So, Sigero's doing some nice damage over the north side. Black Duchy's holding the south side, but I feel like they really need to be building Goliaths. Or even...
You know, Sigero's coming in the north. Sigero's in the north.
Oh yeah, Sigero's got the north. I almost think Banishers would do fine against the Dante. And we have Ravens to deal with the Dante. That's not a bad idea either. It will die. Never mind, that is a bad idea. There are too many Tridents.
And lag.
I guess Zenver must just have CPU issues more than anything. That must be the problem. That's the reason why you'd have that lag. Which sucks. I mean, I'm getting decent frame rate, but that's... I have a lot of processing power. Alright, well, Zenfer's gonna keep going. So it looks like Zenfer thinks that they're done, and I mean, to an extent, yeah, they're right. The West team does have a massive advantage. It would be rather difficult to get back here. Alright, so Zenfer's doing most of the commentary for me about what exactly is happening. So... Yeah, looks like we're going to be... We're probably going to be seeing... I mean, the Dante will probably die. If the Dante dies, that'll be game. I can't imagine that... I mean, 400 has been very persistent. But I'm pretty sure the Dante dies, that we'll call it. I would be very surprised if the game continued afterwards. Zenfer's lost their solar wall. They've lost everything. They've lost their solar wall, they've lost their shield by factory, just about. They're losing all the stuff in their main base. And 400's
using that Dante, right? He's keeping his distance, he's de-gunning pretty much only. He's not really taking any more damage than he's already gotten.
Yeah. That's very true. And he's got repairs going on. And that repair allows for the reclaim to be taken in the process. Which is very smart. The problem, however, is that now that the reclaim is being taken, the Dante is very vulnerable. And there are still a lot of Reapers. So, that Dante is still pushed back, and now the reclaim... I mean, some reclaim is taken, which is good. You want that. But that Dante is still taking a lot of fire. Forced back once again, and the thing is, Sigero has taken out Zenfer. That's the thing. Sigero essentially set up a flanking position from the north side down through to 400's base. So that's really a problem. Like, that's the thing, is that Black Touchy just needs to hold. And Black Touchy's holding well. They're actually pushing a little bit, so they're doing better than holding. And that's all they need to do. Sigero's got all the pushing handled. Like, that pushing is dealt with. So, really, at this point, it's just breaking through the last few bits of resistance, and after that, it's on to, I guess, game three? Maybe? I don't know. It might be... What is my frame rate when I'm running? Okay, I'm getting down to like 20 when we're running. So I guess that... Yeah, I can kind of see. Even with what I have as fairly beefy CPU, I'm still getting 20, 30 frames per second. Mind you, that's also what I'm doing recording. When I'm not recording, it's closer to 60. It's just like... Recording is CPU intensive, so... This game is also super CPU intensive. Everything's CPU intensive. At least everything I'm doing right now. Anyway. Looks like this is pretty much it. The Dante's still alive, but West team has gotten such a huge advantage. Lobster lost their economic advantage just in all the raids and all the damage. They've lost everything. Mostly Zenfer losing their base. That lost West team most of their... the Lobster team most of their economic advantage. And West team, yeah, they've got it. They've so got it. Just a matter of when 400 will surrender. That's pretty much it, is breaking 400 spirit. And once that Dante's done, I think that'll be the thing that'll do it. Because that Dante, the other one's still in production, it's basically not being produced.
It's down.
Yep, there we go. So that should be probably game. Probably? Maybe? That's up to 400 at this point.
Yeah, probably.
And 400 degrees, yep, that's game. So, good match, very even, very close. I mean, we technically hit the time marker, but I think it didn't really matter. It was close enough to be even, so yeah. Wow. So close to time, but hey, it worked. Anyhow, once again... Yep. Unit value. Oh, unit value this time was more Black Duchy than Zagato. Zagato definitely more than the units built. And the income was kind of even, but yeah, definitely, like I said, went back and forth so even for so long. All the stats really are even for so long. Although it seems like 400, like when Zenfer had a lot of units, 400 had very few and vice versa. Anyhow, that is that game, which I don't know if it's going to be the last game. I don't know if that means that it was... I don't think it's the last game. I think it's best of five. No, never mind. Apparently that was it. That's it. Okay, well, in that case, congratulations, Black Duchy and Zagato, for winning first place and 400 Zen for second place, and Google Frog and Orphelius for getting third place. And thank you, Anakin and Hokomoko. Yep. And, of course, we cannot forget our lovely substitute. Hang on. Cortez the Killer. We can't forget them. I just did, but we can't. That was my bad. But yes, thank you also, Cortez the Killer, for subbing for Zenfer for a while. In a sense, you're on the winning team by proxy. Bit of a long and complicated proxy, but still a proxy nonetheless. And that is the thing. Proxies exist. Not sure how meaningful you'd find that, but I hope that makes your day. Anyhow, congratulations everyone for playing. Thank you everyone for watching. Thank you, Barzval, for co-commentating the bracket stage. I hope you all enjoyed that, and have a good night, everyone.